Hello and welcome back to KC Boomer Tech, where we talk about everything tech related to boomers and FUD stuff. Now listen, I'm going to talk to you tonight about the ascension of the Cybermen and where we're up to right now. So let's get into it. So hello again, and listen, I just want to thank everybody for putting up with my voice. I had a bad cold, and that combined with the damage from 9/11, breathing in the dust, it makes my voice very hoarse. So I thank you for taking the time to listen, even though my voice is very hoarse. But anyway, we're going to talk about the Cybermen. So as we can see up to this point, we've had many, many different episodes with very interesting interconnecting cast, interconnecting videos, interconnecting things. And the most interesting now is when we begin in the ascension of the Cybermen is the three subplots that are going on. And they've been very confusing. Now, the one I'm talking about is the scene where this person finds a baby in Ireland and they take it home. We're going to keep him. And they raise him up and he becomes a police officer. And in a scene, we basically see him get shot by a burglar, or we assume he's a burglar, and he falls off a cliff, and we assume he dies, and he comes back to life. And later on, we see him older, but the people around him have not aged, and they give him a retirement package, and then they bring him back into the police station and say, we're going to do a total erasure. Very confusing. A lot of conjecture on what that's going on, and I'm going to be interesting tonight to see how this all pulls in. That leads us to the Doctor and his companions have landed on Earth in the far, far future. They have brought all kinds of equipment to combat the Cybermen, which introduces to cyber drones, which are flying heads of Cybermen. And every device that the Doctor has brought that has combated the Cybermen in the past gets destroyed. And they go running off. They get separated away from the TARDIS. By the way, have you noticed that lately the Doctor seems to get lost from her or his TARDIS a lot? But anyway, we'll get back into that in a second. So, two of them go get away with the Earthlings on a spaceship. I'm trying to figure out where this comes from. And they fly off, and they're going to fly over to this barrier where supposedly all the humans have rights to, and the last humans exist there, and where the Cybermen can't follow. But they get caught into their engines fail, and they end up seeing these giant field of spaceships. They crash land on them, which, by the way, if you crash land onto a landing bay in a ship in space, there is no air, but they got out anyway. And they come to find out that this is a cyber destroyer and has thousands of Cybermen. Kind of insane, because if the cyber wars are over, you would have thought they would have been destroyed. But that being said, our lone Cyberman shows up and, again, remember, he's the one that's half a Cyberman. His arm is in plastic. He was the one that was rejected by the Cybermen, is now the Cyberman leader. And he finds all the packages, all the containers with all the Cybermen. And he says, I am going to help you rise to ascension. And I forgot the exact words, but you get the drift. In other words, it's time for your ascension. And he opens up the first crypt, and he starts cutting into the Cyberman's chest. And we don't know what the heck that's going on. My first thought was, and maybe you did, that he's removing the motion inhibitor. But I don't know, because all of a sudden the Cybermen are behaving much less like Cybermen and more like him. Which leads us to, now, Jody and two other people have landed on the place where the barrier is and are met by a former Earthling who stayed behind to lead people into the barrier where all of the humans, the remaining humans, have gone to. At the same time, the Cybermen have gotten the coordinates and said, "We are going to go to Gallifrey." Okay, you're going to Gallifrey. And then, of course, Jody steps through the barrier, and it's her home planet, Gallifrey, which has been destroyed. And suddenly the Master comes out and starts laughing and starts saying, "Nothing you know, nothing," what was the exact words? And I think you remember, "Nothing you believe is true, and nothing that you have done is the same." And I forgot the exact line because I watched it, but he made no sense. So I'm looking forward to tonight. This was just a brief, quick video of my thoughts. I mean, I got to say, some people are saying this is the worst this is the worst Doctor Who in the entire series, that they don't like it and they don't understand it. And I got to say, there's too many subplots, too many things going on, all of them leading to one episode, which is tonight's episode. So I'll be back to review that episode and we can talk about exactly that. So until then, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. I thank you for watching and putting up with my voice. And listen, you have a great day.